Namaste, little things. This video is about how to motivate children at home. What's as a parent, what's your role? Especially in this pandemic time, parents are really thinking, how can we help kids at home with the studies and how can we support? So let us go to this video. Are you excited to know about the video? Yes, you are. Let's go to the points straight. So I'll give you 10 points today. I will do the next video, the continuation. So the first point is, sit with your kids. Even though when they're little, you need to sit with the kids. When they're very little, you need to read for them. You need to count for them. When they listen, they will feedback that in their mind. And once they grow a little bit more, it will come out automatically. That's with the little kids. But when they grow up more bit, you still sit with them, talk to them and speak to them, encourage them, help them. So they feel like the parents are involved with their studies. So the daily motivation is important. You should help them with the study by step by step. So your motivation and your presence, your comfortness is very important. And the second point is, lay stress on the studies, the learning, getting knowledge, not the grades. You need to tell them, like we say, health is wealth, and also the same way, the education is the wealth. When you get good knowledge, good education, you are successful. You can get any job, whatever you like, be a respected person at your work, any place. So getting wealth in your knowledge is important. As a parent, our responsibility to help your children to get well health in knowledge. Third point is, be on kids' side. In this part, what is the best method? Grow as a child. You need to grow on a child's level to teach them. So talk to them, get the feedback and what, identify their needs, how can you help. Also, you can use your learning experience as a child, how to help me on a kid's side, grow as a child. The fourth point is, you need to have a regular discussion with your child. When I say discussion is a big point, but you should have a good chat with your child when they're young and when they're big. So you need to know what their needs. So discuss and getting to know your child. Even though when the very young age, you need to have a systematic study. Like for example, for my kids, I join an international study program. So I get daily work. So I check the work, I analyze the child, what I need to help them. I know my child, they're good in which subject, where they need help, which part of the subject I need to help. So the study, regular work, at least spend half an hour to 1 hour to studies. In traditional method, that was the tradition. We used to spend at least 1 or 2 hours a day to help the child. This regular study will help them, like their reading skills, their vocabularies, their spelling, and in the maths, they will get mental maths, their counting, the tables. So regular study, reading, writing, everything is important. So if you can, you can join an international program, or there's lots of books available in the market. You can buy age-wise book, 3 to 4, 5 to 6, 7 to 8, 8 to 10, any books, but give them regular work for the continuation of the studies. Because in traditional methods or in our time, we used to get homework from school, so we have a regular study. But nowadays, they don't get regular homeworks, but we can give them small homework. The sixth point is, create a learning environment. If the elder child need to sit down and study, you got siblings, so make them sit down, do some drawing, coloring, picturing. So everybody is doing some work, then the elder kid can study well and better concentration, and they can perform better. So creating an environment at home is very important. Seventh point, though you're in a nursery or a school or high school, you need to talk to the teacher, tutor, assessor, mentor, or the tuition teacher, so you will get a good idea of about your child's learning process. So as a parent is very important. Eighth point is follow your kid's learning style. So the learning can be auditory or visual. Some kids learn better auditory, visual method of teaching. So you need to know which method is good for your child, and he will learn better in that method, and it's your responsibility to provide that kind of teaching method. Ninth point is never ever put your child under pressure. That will only make them stressful. So giving them, helping them, comforting them, ask them, make them to achieve goal, be dedicated person, hardworking person, work together as a parent child. So for this you need to have a good relationship with your child. The 10th point, also you need to listen to your child, what they're thinking, which area they need help. So you need to have a good relationship with your child. Talk to them daily, sit down and listen. Never ever say you don't have time. If you're busy with something, you need, whenever you get time, you need to make sure you sit with your child. Always answer to your child. Never say I don't know. If you don't know, you find it out. And already give you 10 points. The next 10 points will be in the next video. So this is the end of this video. So I'll come with next exciting 10 points in next video. See you then. Bye.